and welcome back to The Mass Reader. We have more tales to unravel, more masks to remove. But can you guess who is behind the mask?
My invisible dog is not much fun. I don't know if he's sad or glum. I don't know if, when I pat his head, I'm really patting his bum instead.
Over the fields and the forests they flew. The dog wagged his tail and the stormy wind blew. Ooh! The witch laughed aloud and held on to her hat. But away blew her bow from her long ginger plait. Down! Cried the witch. And they flew to the ground. They searched for the bow, but no bow could be found. This is one of my favourite stories. Can you name the story? And who am I?
Once there were three owl babies, Sarah and Percy and Bill. They lived in a hole in the trunk of a tree with their owl mother. The hole had twigs and leaves and owl feathers on it. It was their home. One night they woke up and their owl mother was gone.
"Where's Mummy?" asked Sarah.
"Oh my goodness," said Percy.
"I want my Mummy," said Bill.
The baby owls thought.
All owls think a lot.
"I think she's gone hunting," said Sarah.
"To get us our food," said Percy.
"I want my Mummy," said Bill.
But their owl mother didn't come. The owl babies came out of their house and they sat on the tree and waited. A big branch for Sarah, a small branch for Percy, and an old bit of ivy for Bill. "She'll be back," said Sarah.
"Back soon,"
said Percy.
"I want my Mummy,"
said Bill. It was dark in the wood and they had to be brave, for things moved all around them.
"She'll bring us mice and things that are nice," said Sarah.
"I suppose so," said Percy. "I want my Mummy,"
said Bill. They sat and they thought.
All owls think a lot.
"I think we should all come and sit on my branch," said Sarah. And they did, all three together.
"Suppose she got lost," said Sarah.
"Or a fox got her," said Percy.
"I want my Mummy,"
said Bill. And the baby owls closed their owl eyes and wished their owl mother would come. Whoosh! And she came. Soft and silent, she swooped through the trees to Sarah and Percy and Bill.
"Mummy!" they cried. And they all flapped and they danced and they bounced up and down on their branch.
"What's all this fuss?" their owl mother asked.
"You knew I'd come back."
The baby owls thought.
All owls think a lot.
"I knew it," said Sarah. "And I knew it," said Percy.
"I love my Mummy," said Bill.
Let me see. Yes. First, to Mr. Ronald Weasley. Ron went purple in the face. He looked like a radish with bad sunburn. "For the best played game of chess Hogwarts has seen in many years, I award Gryffindor 50 house points." Gryffindor cheers nearly raised the bewitched ceiling. The stars overhead seemed to quiver. Percy could be heard telling the other prefects, "My brother, you know, my youngest brother. got past McGonagall's giant chess set. At last there was silence again. Second, to Miss Hermione Granger, for the use of cool logic in the face of fire, I award Gryffindor House 50 points. Hermione buried her face in her arms. Harry strongly suspected she had burst into tears. Gryffindors up and down the table were beside themselves. They were 100 points up. Third, to Mr. Harry Potter, said Dumbledore. The room went deadly quiet. For pure nerve and outstanding courage, I award Gryffindor House 60 points. The din was deafening. Those who could add up while yelling themselves hoarse knew that Gryffindor now had 472 points, exactly the same as Slytherin. They had drawn for the House Cup. If only Dumbledore had given Harry just one more point. Dumbledore raised his hand. The room gradually fell silent. There are all kinds of courage, said Dumbledore, smiling. It takes a great deal of bravery to stand up to our enemies, but just as much to stand up to our friends. I therefore award 10 points to Mr. Neville Longbottom. Someone standing outside the Great Hall might well have thought some sort of explosion had taken place. So loud was the noise that erupted from the Gryffindor table. Harry, Ron and Hermione stood up to yell and cheer as Neville, white with shock, disappeared under a pile of people hugging him.
Once upon a time, there was a youngster named Goldilocks who lived at the edge of the forest. She was called Goldilocks because her beautiful locks glistened in the sun like gold. Goldilocks was curious by nature. She often looked for and found adventures in the forest. One bright morning, she set out for a stroll in the woods. She came upon a cosy cottage and peeked in at the windows. When she didn't see anyone inside, she knocked on the door. When nobody came to the door, she turned the handle and went right in. Goldilocks did not have the best manners in the forest. Goldilocks didn't realise that the cottage belonged to a family of bears. There was a teeny-sized baby bear, a medium-sized mama bear, and a huge-sized papa bear.
That's all for now, folks. So who do you think is behind the mask?
So who is? Unicorn. Witch. Stormtrooper. Dragon. And bear.